to uninhabited Pacific Islands. More than 5,000 miles from the UK.
One has been inhabited by 14 British men, while a separate island was home to 14 British women. They've been utterly alone.
Oh, shit!
With only the clothes they stand up in and a handful of basic tools.
Pitch it, big fella! Oh. Ooh, snap it!
Filming everything themselves. The women have made it off alive. Tonight it's the final installment of the Men's Island.
You lazy bunch of bone idle bastards!
Survival will be harder than ever.
They'll have to endure the height of the harsh tropical storm season.
This island either wants to decompose you or eat you alive.
It's a scorpion, guys!
They'll have to find their own water and hunt for their own food. With the finishing line in sight, have these modern-day men got what it takes to survive?
I'm going to go to hell for this.
Come on, boys! Song! Hi-yo!
Five weeks ago, 14 British men were dropped on a remote Pacific island.
Glad you're here. Oh, I couldn't have gone much further.
They've had some success with their fishing nets. But not enough to stop their physical decline.
We've been here over a month now. We are starting to starve.
Be careful!
Taking huge risks in the pursuit of food.
Holy shit! Coming off!
He severed one of his tendons.
The group suffered their biggest loss.
He needs to be evacuated.
We'll get him on board ASAP, over.
As 36-year-old Will was forced to leave the island.
I feel devastated that he's gone.
Of all the people you wanted to finish with, he was up there, wasn't he?
We were supposed to be as strong as the team, and now the island's thwarted that. Hate this place. Hate it.
No respite for us, man. Look at that thunder. We're getting screwed again.
Fair weather islanders.
What's going on here?
Whoa! I've got a flipping.
Is a scorpion.
Shit!
Right, don't move.
I do not want to get stung.
Of course you don't. Right.
Please be quick about it.
Whoa, let me get
that
way.
Don't
cut it off.
Don't
throw
it off on his foot.
Flick
it off.
Flick it off.
Yeah,
boy! Give it a shot, yeah.
Ain't that the thing with this island? 1 minute it's all calm, and then boom! There's a scorpion on my leg!
I'll eat him. Horrible little thing.
Take him.
Yeah.
Take him down.
Well done, big fella.
The men have been living on the island for an unprecedented 36 days. And they're now entering uncharted territory. And that's why this time, only the mentally strong are gonna make it to the end. Living for 5 weeks on an extreme low-calorie diet, consisting mainly of fish, limpets, and coconuts, the men have been getting weaker by the day.
Pounds just keep dropping off, gentlemen.
To make sure their physical decline doesn't become life-threatening, Dr. Pierce has been monitoring their weight using scales from his medical kit.
Come on, you big streak of piss.
That puts me just under 10 stone.
My bollocks weigh more than that.
Jesus.
28-inch waist.
28-inch waist.
Jesus Christ.
You could just buy boys' clothes when you get home now, see the absolute packet.
It's baby gap, mate.
You get baby gap.
Since arriving on the island, the men have shed nearly 30 stone between them.
The weight loss was always going to be dramatic, but I was not expecting it to be as severe as it was.
And maybe, just maybe, the storm has been kind and dropped us a fresh coconut.
Determined to halt the decline, the men redouble their efforts to find food.
We're going to go and check the shit out of these nets.
Good luck, fellas.
Oh, for my legs, it's not working today.
I had that yesterday, just... Have you worn your boots recently?
No.
God, dude, do...
Too heavy.
Do not try putting them on, I'll tell you now. Oh, it's a bit weightier than last time, isn't it?
The fishing nets have been a lifeline for the men, but as they get weaker, taking the raft out to check them has become an increasingly difficult task.
Come on now, let's have just one or two.
Oh, bollocks. It's all snagged.
Oh, this is getting annoying now.
Today, there isn't a single fish to reward Charlie and Piers for their efforts.
You all right?
I think it's dangerous now, actually, living in his nets, in all honesty. All of us are just skin and bone, and it's not really, I think it's safe anymore.
Ah! We've eaten almost every single coconut on this whole island. All the ones left are pretty much rotten. This was the last little stash I knew about.
Depleted a lot of the limpet stores already, really.
Even the men's once reliable food sources appear to be running dry.
We have truly decimated the fish within 3 metres of the boundary of this island, haven't we?
Twenty-four hours ago, we were conquering this island. Nets were full of fish. 24 hours later, we're in tatters. This could go from bad to worse very easily.
Every single one of these guys is going to have mega low moments. It's just the reality of being out in the wild, being tired, being bitten to death, being hungry. You just have those moments. And one of the key lessons I've learned is that the pain, the discomfort, it never lasts forever. Keep your eyes on the light.
Can I just show you something? There's something here that you might all want to see.
Where is it?
Come with me. It's not my
fault. Is it worth it, Sam?
Is it edible?
It's good.
I'm taking my knife, just in case.
It's Bear Grylls, isn't it?
And it's a hope as well. Look at this.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, baby turtle. Oh.
It's alive. And it's making its way to the beach. And if there's one, there's probably a few more. Isn't that amazing?
That's incredible.
There's the others, look.
The other one. Oh, yeah.
Can you see the two of them?
Yeah.
Oh.
It's gorgeous, isn't it?
Privilege.
It's a real privilege, isn't it? I just noticed it. I was coming back from the end of the beach. I just saw this thing wriggling in the sand. And I thought, what's that? And just to see that is absolutely amazing.
Such fighters. You can sort of see them toasting in the sun, can't you?
Yeah.
It's life and death for these guys, you know what I mean? It's like each one of us, you know, whether it's here on this island or in life, we're sort of fighting our own personal battles.
Should we help him?
Come on, mate. Get out of that. Help him along.
Come on, chap. Go.
And maybe I'm doing a completely wrong thing and shoot me down, but if there's a chance of this little dude living rather than dying, I want him to live.
Go on, little fella.
Take to the water.
God, that was one of the most incredible things I've ever seen.
Really touching.
Those guys have just been born, just been hatched. All they're thinking about is just surviving. Get into that water. It just puts everything into perspective.
Such a beautiful sight.
You okay? Yeah, tired, that's all.
Late afternoon.
Ah!
The turtles have been a welcome distraction, but after more than 5 weeks on a starvation diet and no sign of their next meal, the men are in bad shape.
Tired. Just tired. I've usually got lots of energy, and I like being enthusiastic about things. I like doing things. But I've been so tired.
I'm sort of starving, wasting away, and I know my body is just like, you need fuel, but there's no escaping it. You're so aware that you're going downhill fast.
Nah, he's gone, I think.
They're all fucking dying.
On the beach, some of the baby turtles are also on their last legs.
They're just frying up hot little bodies.
I wish they'd woken up at night. Breaks my heart, but either we leave these little guys to rot or for the birds to pick at them or we eat them. And this, by any definition, is a moral dilemma.
Are we definitely boiling these little buggers up, are we?
What do you think?
I'm not eating it.
No?
I think it's disgusting. I think you're all inhumane if you eat them, to be honest.
The turtle who died on the beach, there's rumours of that going in a broth, and you say for ethical reasons or whatever, there's no way I'm drinking any of that at all.
I'm going to go to hell for this.
Despite strong feelings in the group, Sam makes a decision.
Eat, not eat. I think we should eat them. I think these guys are done.
What do I? Like? Oh.
It's like a hard-boiled egg.
Hey, Christ, they're beautiful, aren't they? Oh, that's wrong. That is so wrong.
I've eaten some fucked up shit in my time. This tastes a cake.
Salut, my little turtly friends.
That shell and all?
Yep, every bit. Raphael. Michelangelo. Is anyone else claiming these turtles?
Go on, then. Go on, don't be shy. I have two. Oh my god, they're good. They're absolutely stunning.
Are you eating them or not eating them?
I am not eating them, mate.
All right, okay.
Weird how you can feel nothing for a snake or an iguana. And baby turtle has died anyway. It's weird. Difficult to eat. But I scoffed them down.
It is quite delicious.
I'm sure it is, but a bizarre principle that I'm sticking to now.
With only half the group able to bring themselves to eat the baby turtles, they bring little relief to the malnourished men.
It's becoming an experiment in starvation. It's really tough to keep going when you're so hungry. And the future looks pretty bleak when it comes to food.
Men have now been living alone on the island for more than 5 weeks.
It doesn't smell too good.
Since the demise of their fishing nets, the food situation has become critical.
Resources on our back doorstep have run out.
A handful of dead baby turtles provided a temporary reprieve for some of the men. But today, they're back to nothing.
About a week ago, we saw pig trotter marks and were keen to lay some pig traps and hopefully be able to bring back the bacon.
When you're deprived of food, it literally becomes all-consuming. It's all you think about. It's all that motivates and drives you. I need something.
But hard though it is when they're running on empty, the men can't afford to neglect the other survival essentials they've worked so hard to maintain over 5 weeks, especially team spirit.
Well done, chefs.
Well, that, chaps, is delicious.
Is that the obligatory pubic hair?
After an unsuccessful morning, the only meal the hunting party have been able to muster is limpet broth, which is quickly devoured by the men.
What are you eating? What have I missed?
The group's oldest member, Phil, has arrived back in camp later than the others.
We all served up the food and completely forgot about Phil.
What are you talking?
Is there any broth there?
It'd be a negative.
What I'm going to do is I'm just going to hide behind my T-shirt. Wow. In the hope that he doesn't see me.
Does he
make
more than vodka now?
It's the first time since the men arrived on the island that they have forgotten to feed one of their own.
Everyone looked after themselves and forgot me.
Oh, my God, I'm so sorry.
That's OK. Just means that you all owe me. That's all.
So we weren't acting like this 4 weeks into the experiment, but now we are coming up to 5.5 weeks, and a lot of people are starting to fray around the edges. Some of them are fraying, some of them are coming away at the seams.
What's he doing?
I don't know. He's running now. I don't know.
He
completely lost it.
I don't think he believes you. I miss you.
Okay, finally, let's get the fuck out of here.
That's it.
We'll see you later on, mate.
Desperate for a decent meal and having exhausted the resources close to camp, Sam Brown and Kyle head off to look further afield.
Now we can go get some coconuts. Fingers crossed.
For the first time, they're heading to the unexplored south side of the island, an arduous 5 kilometer round trip across unforgiving terrain. Having set off at 4 p.m, they have just 2 hours to make it there and back before nightfall.
We might have left this slightly late.
Guys, there's an iguana here.
Where is it?
In the remaining hours of daylight, the other men are doing their best to find a meal closer to home.
Where is it?
It's in the fucking tree here. I'm pointing to it.
We're in a fucking forest. 12 o'clock, 11 o'clock, where are you standing?
Wow. Fracture is occurring in the group. We arguments, bickering. And that's got to be down to the hunger and the tiredness.
We haven't got a fucking clue where it is.
Can everyone see me? If you can see me, I'm pointing at it.
Well, where is it?
It's down towards you, Barney, Barney, Barney.
It's not that way, it's not that way.
Yeah, no, he's not that way.
Back.
Bollocks.
So are you struggling a bit today?
Yeah, today's been a tough day, actually.
Sam and Kyle have now been trekking through dense jungle for more than an hour. In an attempt to find out if the island's south coast has any untapped sources of food.
Slippy as buggery here, Kyle, just be careful.
Cheers, mate.
This is gonna be a fucking nightmare on the way back.
Is it like beach or cliff?
Mate, be careful, be careful, be careful. Be careful. This is a no-go. We were hoping to find a nice sandy beach and a coconut tree. Instead, we find this. Fucking lethal. One slip up here and we'll die.
On the other side of the island, farmer Charlie is the first to return to camp after a fruitless day's hunting.
Oh, fucking hell! I've come back to find the fire down to about 1 square inch of embers after a month of constant burn.
We're getting a bit complacent now.
How much water's left?
Oh, no.
You can see the standards of the camp are going lower and lower and lower because people are just starting not to give a shit anymore.
Kept this fire going for a month now. There was no smoke coming out of that whatsoever. And there was an ember about an inch square. But it was either, no, yeah, exactly. Barney, Phil, Roscoe...
But that's not pointing fingers, it's not helpful.
No, just saying it was either one of you five. It cannot happen again. True.
Most of the group have now been back at camp for the past hour, but Sam and Kyle have yet to return from their expedition to the south of the island.
Are we worried about them, lads?
It's now pitch black.
Shit it is, isn't it? Yeah.
It's not the ideal time to be out foraging.
My worry is when you're in the middle of the jungle, in the dark...
Yeah, it's got no navigation. You've got high tide as well, so you can't even get round.
This is the first time any of the men have failed to get back to camp before dark. With the weather worsening and concerns growing over Sam and Kyle's safety, the men muster a search party.
Let's go, let's try and find them.
Bloody hell.
Fucking should be going out at 4 o'clock.
Yeah, they're certainly not equipped for a night out on the fucking
jungle on their own.
You've got a very steep drop down here.
Sam! Kyle! Sam! Kyle!
It's not looking good, man.
They would not find us here. Not a chance.
This is Kyle and Sam in the dark, trying to trek back towards our camp. We'll see how far we get.
With no sun in the sky, it's hard to get your bearings.
Really, really unforgiving terrain.
Charlie! Charlie! Sam!
Shout the bird.
Oh, fuck. This is fucking stupid.
I feel tormented out here.
Come on, boys! Sam! Kyle!
Having searched for an hour with no sign of the missing pair, the group reluctantly head back to camp.
Truth known, you want to get him and give him a clip for being so stupid and putting us all through this. Because the only thing we are going to be thinking now, all night...
I know, is how their safety...
How are they? I hope they're OK.
Familiarisation makes us think that we've got it licked.
Yeah.
That's what we've done.
We ain't got nothing licked, have we?
Nah.
Mother Nature in this island and bite you whenever she feels fit. Ah. Fuck, four rocks.
Oh. Fucking hell.
Desperately trying to get back to camp, Sam and Kyle have hit the treacherous stretch of coast where Will had his accident.
This is getting dangerous.
One wrong move here could easily prove fatal.
Fuck's sake!
Now, this next bit, you have to take it really, really slow because it's slippery as hell on the boulders and we've only got one head torch between us. I am genuinely shitting myself now.
I genuinely don't think that they know where they are.
It's a bit eerie, actually, sometimes. Maybe I've seen one too many horror films. I didn't think I was scared of the dark, but out here, you have to sort of steel yourself that you're not scared of the dark.
Hello? I see a light.
Boys!
Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Good to see you, man.
We are so pleased that you're back.
I don't think I've ever been so massively relieved in my whole life.
Well done, boys. Glad to have you all. Well done, boys.
Well done, boys.
My pleasure.
The two prodigal sons returned. Thank God they're back home, safe and sound.
The other side of the island is just horrible. It's all sheer cliff.
Yeah.
The waves hitting it like...
Yeah, man.
So, listen, sorry to keep you guys up for so long.
Anyone, but we got back, that's what counts.
Well, the past few days have taken the whole group really to their limits, both physically and mentally. Not only have they forgotten to feed people and neglected the essential tasks of fire and water, but their recklessness brought the group close to losing two more men.
If they don't start looking after each other, thinking smart, being resourceful and surviving, they haven't got a cat's chance.
The whole thing for me, it all comes down to us getting complacent about everything. Thinking that we're now starting to own this island a little bit when really we have
very
little control. That comes down to slipping off rocks, running out of wood, which we'll blatantly do tomorrow.
Yeah.
Whatever it may be, let's just get our drills a little bit back in order.
Yeah, let's get back with basics.
Morning calls and stuff like that. Let's get back into them because we're all fucking shite at the minute.
So let's get the basics right.
Yeah, it would be vulgar to finish in such a weak way. We are here and we have grown so close together that we go for it. Doing the things we want to do that are exciting and fulfil all them things we've always wanted to do since being here. Let's go for it.
Let's do this, chaps, come on.
Woo!
I don't want to finish weak, I want to finish strong. Catch some pigs, catch some animals,
finish this adventure the way we want to. I'm not going out like a wet fart. I want to go out strong.
Mum and Dad, there's so much I want to tell you. Because I just wanted to say, being here, has made me realise just how much I love you all. I don't want you to be worried about me in any sense. And the reason I'm being kind of a little bit nearly tearful is because I just can't wait for that moment to see you all. But I'm having the time of my life, I really am.
Hi-ho, hi-ho, it's off to work we go.
Early morning. After a difficult day yesterday, the men are determined to redouble their efforts and leave the island on a high.
I'm amazed what washes up on these damn beaches.
A snake! So I get a machete.
Ooh, nice shot.
Come on.
It's so funny, because on day one, we'd be like, oh, shit, there's a snake. And now we're like, oh, it's just another snake.
Today, I really got a sense that our teamwork, our team ethic, really came back. It just seems to be a real pulling together today.
Woo! I got a whopper.
We've got fish!
Holy shit!
Hello, hello, hello. Hello.
Oh, what a nice. Oh, that
going
is
a beauty,
beauty
as well.
Never in my life have I made my own sashimi before.
I've gone from eating one fish maybe every 6 months to now having it raw on a beach, on a home-whittled table, and loving it.
Dig in.
To you, sir.
To many more days like this.
Oh.
Mmm.
That is just so...
Succulent doesn't do it justice, does it?
Fresh.
It's delicious.
One of the things I want to see in this experiment is whether these guys can use all their collective resources and brains and muscles to not just survive, but to really thrive, to build community, to have fun, to work out efficient sources of finding food, to, you know, to really start to thrive and separate us from the animals.
When Oinky makes his way to my front door, I will consume the entire fucking animal.
The men's renewed spirit has brought fresh optimism about the prospect of catching a meatier meal.
Ah! What have we got here? These look like little trot marks to me.
Oh, my fucking God.
That is exciting, isn't it? They're going in the bushes, so obviously it's a bit too hot for them, and they're going back in.
They're definite pig tracks.
Please!
Oh, my God, bacon butties. Oh. We're all fantasizing the other day about what we're going to do to Oinky. Delusions of grandeur of smoking him and putting him on a spit and having crackling and God knows all sorts. What we'd give for that.
Damn, it's warm, Barney.
It's getting hot, mate, isn't it, eh?
Yeah.
Further down the beach, Vic, Barney and the two Sams are also on the hunt for a decent supper.
Shit the dog. Shit the dog.
What?
Look at that, look at that. There's something there. Stop, stop, stop. Don't move, don't
move.
There is
where?
A pig. Okay, stop. There's a pig in there. There is a pig thing in there.
No way.
Don't move, don't move. Vic, don't move. Let's have a think about this.
Okay. And he was just having a little snooze in the shade.
So we need to get behind him because that is going to disappear straight in there.
I'll go up the sand.
All right. I'll go with you then, yeah?
Yeah. Don't you worry. We'll hold him down. If I'm eating pig tonight, I'll fight the bastard.
Just keep very calm.
When cornered, pigs can be incredibly aggressive animals.
It's going to run like stink.
They've got razor-sharp tusks and a vicious bite.
Woo! Woo! I thought he was going to turn and bite me. I crapped myself.
Yeah, he's gone.
Gosh, that was so much quicker than I thought. That was just like...
Listen, it's done.
This is how we roll.
I wasn't expecting you to stab him. We had, you know, I understand.
I didn't expect you to stab him at all.
I did.
Mate, that would kill you.
That would hurt. That You'd would, be off the line.
That would fuck
will.
You up.
Yeah.
This is a fucking adult pig.
Yeah. This is like a hog, isn't it?
Yeah. These things wreck people.
Do you know what I mean?
Jesus, look at that tusk.
That would go through to bone, wouldn't it?
Oh, yeah.
6 weeks ago, I would have been very slow to draw a knife and ram it into a large mammal's throat. Now, I didn't even think, I didn't even hesitate.
Oh, easy peasy.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, there's going to be so much meat on that head.
In 21st century Britain, I think we're so used to getting all of our meat pre-packaged off a supermarket shelf. And in many ways, we've kind of lost touch with actually where it comes from.
Meat on his legs, ribs, back legs, the lot.
Many people understandably find the whole idea of killing an animal, they find it either cruel or definitely upsetting. And yes, it's never pleasant to take a life, but in a survival situation, when it comes down to it, it's a simple choice. Them or you.
Nose to tail, we're gonna eat every piece of you, Mr. Pig.
I can see home from here, boys.
I don't believe it. I don't believe it. It cannot be a trotter.
Boys!
Oh, my dear.
Ain't you done this thing, eh?
Ooh. Yes.
Yes.
Okay, 3, 2, 1,
go.
Oh, Mr. Piggy.
That was hard work.
Yeah?
And you're this bloody pig. Get in there.
Oh, that is great.
Absolutely brilliant.
Yeah, get in there.
A pig of this size, weighing up to 200 pounds, contains tens of thousands of calories and could feed the 10 men for the next few days.
I think there's a lung there.
That's, yeah, you don't want to eat lung.
Oh, we're going to have pork belly. Oh, God, that is like barbecue food.
Yeah.
Has anybody got any preference about who's served first today?
Yes. I would say Phil.
After the group forgot to feed Phil yesterday, by way of an apology, they give him first dibs on the spoils.
I'm having a meat orgasm. Which one's the kidney?
Anyone that knows me will know one of my favourite meals is liver and bacon. Guess what that is? Liver. Oh. And then to add to that, kidney.
That beats any crocodile, any fish, anything I've had in this island, 100%.
The pig is the men's first taste of meat in weeks, and nothing is going to waste.
I think that's testicle-y.
I'm going to eat everything of this pig. I'm even going to eat its little willy.
I'd eat some pig penis.
There's a very unique flavour in there.
Does that taste like dick?
Yeah, it's dick.
It worries me quite a lot that you know what death tastes like.
Vic!
Yeah?
I think we're raising the sign, mate.
After surviving on the island for almost 6 weeks, the men have decided to make a tribute to their achievement.
Gentlemen, by the power invested in me, I name this camp the Croc and Trotter.
The Croc and Trotter!
I'm really looking forward to this ending and looking back and just saying, wow, I did that. I accomplished. I succeeded. We conquered the island.
We're named and ready to rock. Shall we play Toss the Caver?
Yeah! Yeah.
Right, boys, first game, let's go! 3, 2, 1, toss my caver!
Go, Charlie!
Man! No, oh. No!
That's it!
Go,
one, son!
Yeah!
Now, it's the first time that the whole group has really let our hair down and not worried about water or wood or survival or
will we eat or will we not? It's kind of like, let's just get together as lads and have fun. I mean, I wish, looking back, I wish we'd done more of it.
Well, that's one of the highlights of our entire time here.
What I have experienced many times in the wild is an incredible sense of achievement that is very hard to get in everyday life.
Catch it! Oh, keep going!
And I think when you battle for 7 or 8 hours in a torrential rainstorm with just a couple of sticks to make a fire,
you've got to look for opportunities, however small, to have fun. It's almost like nourishment, but for the soul.
Take the stray!
Take the stray! Yeah.
Call it a draw?
A draw!
I feel amazing. I feel relaxed, I feel empowered, I feel like we're masters of this island. I'll treasure this moment. I really, really will. This is what the island's all about. This and a handful of other moments. This feeling. I hope I never forget it.
Well, here we are. We are at the end of this magnificent, magnificent journey. Overwhelming sadness that I miss my wife and kids so much. Not so much sadness, just, God, how long can this truly go on for? I'd like to see them soon, if possible. Sooner the better for me. Sooner the better.
What do you think of that, beauty?
Shit.
Here it goes. Look, look, look. Ooh, there's some heat off this bad boy.
Woo! Look at that!
Look at that go!
It didn't take long, did it?
Ocean's Elevenses, this is our last night on the island.
Yeah!
Yes!
Yes!
Good.
Best night so far? I think so. Has to be, doesn't it?
Awesome. Love it.
Home's within spitting distance. Really enjoying it. Everyone's spirits are really high.
Wow.
The men have now survived on the island for 40 days.
Would you guys like to hear a little Robbie Burns poem that I wrote this morning?
I would love to hear Robbie Burns
yes,
poem.
I'd love to.
Dear islands, our islands, this new family does hail. As you've chucked everything at us, but nobody has failed. Yeah! On the contrary, dear island, as our stay grew longer, we may have reduced in numbers, but we've grown ever stronger. For 6 long weeks, we've battled hunger, tides, exhaustion, the weather. But with British bulldog spirit, we triumphed with heart, soul, and endeavour. You've been cruel, uncomfortable, and brutal to us all. With freezing rain, dangerous seas, and rocks that make us fall. You have dangerous beasts that can kill, maim, and maul.
It's a scorpion.
But we baited, trapped, killed, cooked, and ate them all.
Oh, delicious. So good.
But dear islands, our islands, we will never forget the incredible journey we've shared since our new family met.
Good bunny.
So the question is, our island, can British blokes survive?
Get the fucking camera off!
The answer is no. Dear island, we didn't just survive, but thrive.
Excellent. Wow!
So I'm on my way to pick up the men after 6 weeks, you know, and to be honest, I'm pretty nervous just about what I'm going to find. You know, are they going to be emaciated wrecks or are they going to look pretty healthy? You know, are they going to be broken men or will they have figured out how to survive and thrive?
It is quite strange though, isn't it?
What bit?
It's finished.
Yeah, yeah. Within an hour, you will step off and never, ever step back on.
Brett, it's been an honour serving you, gentlemen.
Yes, sir.
Good effort, gents.
I feel quite proud of our little gang.
The island has taught me an incredible sense of unity. And we've shared everything that we've had here on this island. Doesn't matter if it was the smallest fish, we've shared it between everyone.
I feel thrilled to have made it this far with you all. It sounds fucked up, but I feel like I'm going to actually miss you lot.
I think I'm leaving the island with a kind of renewed sense of confidence and some friends. Some more friends, should I say.
Here we go, boys.
No way!
Here he is. Yes! This is our man.
This is it, lads.
It's Bear Grylls.
Bear Grylls, lads.
It's only Bear Bloody Grylls.
Bloody Daddy.
Bloody Bloody Daddy!
Bloody
Daddy! Look at you guys. I thought I smelled bad. I mean, that is the smell of honest hard work. Yeah.
Glad to see ya.
Thanks for coming back.
I'm glad I made it to the end. I am super, super, super glad I made it to the end.
Well done, you guys. Wow. It's like you've been through a war zone. But those smiles tell a story.
So how are you feeling?
Fantastic.
Glad to see you now.
Fantastic.
Yeah. Glad you're here. You.
As a band of brothers, it's not a band of brothers anymore. It's a family. Love them and hate them. They're here forever with you, and it was fantastic.
So we're going to get you off the island. One last thing you guys want to do?
Yes.
Yeah. Woo! Boys.
Come on, guys.
Kyle, you started this fire. You tell us when to end it, pal.
I'm proud to say that I've made it here with you guys, Ocean's Leventers. Let's quench the fire.
Quench the fire, guys. Get in there! Yes?
I think what's interesting is that you realise they've actually become a really tight unit. You know, that's why there's emotion at the end when they're hugging each other, because they've been through the fire together and they've come out of it stronger.
Well done, boys! Let's grab his tackle and get out of here,
yeah?
Get the fuck out of here.
Come on.
Get the fuck out of here.
If I got that chance again, give me about a year or half a year, I'll do it again. But ask me to do it tomorrow, I'll probably tell you to piss off.
Just because you're over 40, just because you're over 50, just because you're almost 60, doesn't mean you're spent. A can-do attitude goes a long way in this life.
It's William!
What's happening, boys?
Good to see you!
Oh, man, I'm so glad.
Wow, you all stink! Oh, no, it's good. I couldn't let you guys get to the end without me.
Hello, is that you?
All right, I'm fine. You? It's absolutely brilliant, babe. Oh, God, your voice is beautiful.
Hello?
If I had a look at it overall, you know, they've built community. They've learnt a compassion and a care for each other, a respect for each other. They've worked their nuts off. They've understood the heart of survival isn't about knowledge. It's about embracing failure, making mistakes, and never giving up. And that's why, at the end of it, what they've done is inspiring. They've gone through a journey together and come out of it stronger, tighter, and it's why they've learned the beginning of a mastery over this environment. They can call themselves survivors. They've earned it the hard way. Wonder if you have what it takes to survive on the island? Go to channel4.com/the island for information about the next series.
How did the men and women endure the island? Access all areas in Surviving the Island tomorrow at 9. Next Wednesday, you never know what might happen, and then you're on your way to St. George's. Brand new 24 hours in A&E at 9. But coming up, they do big fry or small fry, getting Bradford back into work. Meet the flash team of recruiters at the job centre.